Junior Power Kids, welcome to the clubhouse. I am so excited that you get to listen to our Bible story today. So we know that it is the month of July, and I love July. It's summertime, it's hot out, and I bet that most of you probably went to a picnic or had a picnic last week, and maybe you even got to watch some fireworks to celebrate the 4th of July. It is so fun. So here at church, we are calling it I Spy all month long, where we are looking for things that we can see that help us believe in Jesus. It is so much fun. And we know that today's story is from my very favorite book called the Bible. That's right. And how many books are in the Bible? 66. You guys are so smart. And how many parts is it broken into? Two. That's right. The Old Testament and the New Testament. Today's story is from the New Testament, and it is about a man named Paul. All right, and so since we are calling it I Spy this month, remember to get your pretend binoculars or maybe even some real binoculars out to help me tell the story. And so when I say I Spy, you're going to look around for what I'm talking about. I've got my handy dandy binoculars. All right, so today's story is about a man named Paul. You remember Paul. We heard about Paul weeks ago. We've talked about Paul a lot, actually. He used to be Saul and used to not like people that believed in Jesus. And then he changed his mind after talking to Jesus, and he became known as Paul and spent his whole life traveling and telling people all about Jesus. He was amazing. Well, one of the cities that he traveled to was called Athens. Can you say Athens? Let me hear it. Athens. Good. And so the people in Athens worshipped statues. So let's see. I spy with my little eye something that's made of rock and can't hear and can't talk. Oh, I see it. I spy a statue here. I spy a statue here. So statues are like made of rock or maybe even sometimes bronze or gold. Statues can't hear. They can't talk. They're just like made of rock, right? So Paul was there and he saw all these statues that the people of Athens worship like their god. And so Paul looked at the Athens people and he said, you know, you guys have a lot of statues, but you're really missing something. You're missing the one true God. And the people wanted to hear about this. So Paul taught them all about how God made the whole world and everything in it. He made the sun, the moon, the stars, the plants, the animals. The people were amazed and wanted to hear more. And so then Paul told how God not only made the world, but how God made people. So I spy with my little eye somebody that God made. It's you. That's right. God made you. God made me. God made everybody. He gave us the eyes we have, the skin we have, the hair we have. He made us short. He made us tall. God made us, and he loves each one of us. And so Paul told the people that, and they were even more amazed and wanted to hear more. So Paul told them about how God loves us so much, and he made us to be friends with him. But because of our sin, we couldn't be. So he sent his only son named Jesus. That's right. And so Paul told them all about how Jesus came to the earth and died on the cross to save us from our sins. And the people were amazed. Now, some of them didn't like these stories, but some of them loved the stories. And some of them believed in Jesus because of the things that Paul taught them. And so we know that Jesus loves everybody, right? And we know that we can believe that because of even the things that Paul saw and the disciples saw, and they wrote it down and they told other people so that we can know all about Jesus and how much he loves us. And the other thing I want to tell you guys is you can not only believe in Jesus, you can believe in Jesus and love Jesus and follow Jesus. You can also be like Paul, and you can tell other people about Jesus. And like I always tell you guys, you are the best at this because you guys are so smart and so cute, and people love to hear from you. So you make sure that you remember to tell people all about Jesus. See you next time. See you next time.